All right, what's up, guys? So back, a little short one. Some good news. We already made a video talking about the numbers of Strive's release. You know, the Steam numbers, the player base, the first, you know, the initial first day or second day or whatever. It was, you know, it broke Street Fighter V all-time records. It broke Tekken all-time records. It broke some other game. It broke basically every fighting game except for Dragon Ball FighterZ, which, you know, Dragon Ball's got the IP, man. Guilty Gear ain't beating that. So that was really good. It's really exciting. Some people, I remember Obama made a tweet, was like, hold on. It was because of, rollback and marketing, and Steam is bigger. A lot of people didn't want to say the game was fun or good, but, you know, at the end of the day, you can come up with whatever reasoning you want, but the game did really well. We didn't know how well it did, and then this is the news from today. So, ready? 300,000 worldwide. So, I don't know how game stuff works. I think, like, shipping and sales aren't the same thing, but shipping 300K means that they expect to sell like 300K, right? So pretty good early sales here. So congratulations. You know, people were worried, you know, if you are a new Guilty Gear friend, if you're a Striver, you're not familiar with the 2 year build up to the great war of Strive. You know, there are people like dead on arrival, games dead on arrival. You know, it's not going to appeal to the non-Guilty Gear pros, like, you know, no one, who they're making this game for, like, nobody knows this thing, but it looks like the game did well. So, 300,000, you know, compared to some other stuff, if you're a Call of Duty friend or something, you know, it might not seem like too much, but if we look at Guilty Gear sales traditionally, ready, look at this. So, look at FW, that's first week, right here. So, Exert Sign and Exert Sign on PS3 and PS4. Those were the original games there. So, if you, 34, 13, you know, it's all, let's just round up to 50. So, about 50K copies were sold of Exert, and now Strive has shipped 300,000. So, six times the Exert sales there, right there, right? Just, I think Strive's going to keep going from here, too, right? It's going to keep going here. So, great. What would have happened if there was no rollback, though, right? Isn't that crazy? Isn't that crazy? This game was going to launch without rollback. Remember that? It was going to launch without. So 300K, the reception is great. I think people are still picking it up. You know, of course, the player base is going to go down and all fighting games go down. But I think it's going to stabilize at a lot higher than Guilty Gear's ever been. So it's great news, right? It's great news. I don't know why, even with all this, like, good news, even with all this good news, even with, like, all the players, all the tournaments, the sales, you know, there's still some people on the sidelines that are still, like, I don't know if it's being stubborn. I don't know if it's being stubborn, just being angry or something. But people are still, like, really trying to, like, the game's it's going to fail. Like, just with 2 weeks, it's going to fail. Just wait, it's going to fail. People really want the game to do a terrible job. But damn it, it's a good thing, man. 300,000 people. People from all different genres. Like, this is the biggest Guilty Gear's ever been, right? You should be happy about that. You know, even if you're an OG Guilty Gear friend who couldn't make top 8 11's tournament, you should be happy. Even if the game is not for you, you know, if you like the series and everything, it's a good thing, man. And, you know, the good news for you is if your old game, if your favorite Guilty Gear is really that good, whether it's Plus R or Exert, if those games are really that amazing and that wonderful, now you have a huge pool of new players that you can bring back to your game, right? You know, all these dudes that are getting exposed to the series for the first time in the Guilty Gear Strive, you know, maybe they're going to be wanting to play more. They're like, man, I really like Guilty Gear. What other games are there? Like, hey, man, why don't you try out Exert? Why don't you come play Plus R? It's like $2 on Steam and rollback and things like that, you know? I'm sure the success of Strive is going to help the older Guilty Gear games. Will you ever get that precious Rev 3 you've been waiting for, or Plus R 2.0? I don't know about that, buddy, but, you know. But, congratulations once again. But, again, even though these numbers are great, I was just thinking about this. Look at this, right? We made a video on this. Like, damn, Tekken is a beast of a fighting game if you think about it. 7 million, that's just for Tekken 7. So every single version of Tekken has sold millions and millions of copies. Even during the quote-unquote, what is it, the dark ages of the FGC, like Harada talked about it. He was like, yeah, even when it was the dark ages of the FGC, he's like, Tekken was shipping and selling millions of copies. Like, it's crazy how big Tekken is. But yeah, it is also boosted. You mentioned, yeah, they have, like, crazy sales and stuff. It goes on sale. It has an Xbox player base, which it doesn't, or which Strive doesn't. But I wonder, how big can Guilty Gear go? Could it hit a million? I think it probably could at this rate, man. I don't know. If I keep making videos, let's focus on crossplay. You add crossplay, fix them lobbies, couple sales. We're going to see Strive hit a million. It's going to be great. There we go. Congratulations. All I want to say congratulations. Just an update for people that didn't see it. Congrats to the devs. Your decision paid off. Even though you got a couple angry dudes on Twitter, a couple real fans, that understand what Guilty Gear really is, it looks like you made the right decision. The game's a big success. But let me know what you think. How it's been about a week now, a week and a half. How have you been enjoying the game so far? Did you not buy it yet? What are you waiting for? Are you waiting for a sale? Do you just not want to play it? I bought it twice. I got PC and PS4. I'm doing my part. Put it out on Switch and I'll buy that one too. But yeah, let me know what you think. Leave a comment and I'll see you next one. Peace.